Continuing on with the rest of the rabbit dissection, we're going to look at the circulatory system and just a few of the large major vessels that the rabbit has. Now, I want you to pay attention to the coloration of the blood vessels as I point these various ones out. They inject the rabbits with a red latex and a blue latex to help identify the veins and the arteries. If it's a vein, you're actually going to see that it's going to be injected with blue latex. That indicates that we're looking at a vein. Veins are always going to carry blood to the heart. Red latex is what they use to inject the arteries with. And arteries are always going to carry blood away from the heart. So think of arteries, A for away. So we'll see that coloration, and some will be a little bit more vibrant than others as we move on down through the different blood vessels. But I want to point that out to you that, again, red latex is going to indicate arteries. Blue latex are going to indicate veins. All right, so we're going to start out at the heart and give you a basic kind of pathway of blood as it moves on through the heart. So the veins, two large main veins of the heart, are going to be collecting blood from the upper and lower parts of the body and dumping it into the right atrium. So I'm going to move my heart over here. This is the right side of the rabbit. I'm going to move over here, and I want to point out this large blue blood vessel right here. Remember, blue is for veins. This is bringing back deoxygenated blood from the upper, any area above the heart. Better way to say that. And it's going to dump it into this chamber that's going to be here where this flap is, that's called the right atrium. This is the superior vena cava. Now, if we pick up the heart and we look at the underside of the heart, still a little bit more towards the right side of the rabbit, we're going to see another blue tip of the blue vessel right here. We'll see this a little bit better as we move down into the rabbit, into the lower parts in the abdominal cavity. But this is the inferior vena cava. The inferior vena cava is going to collect blood that's going to be below the heart and send it back to the heart. Both the inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava are going to bring blood back to the right atrium of the heart. The blood will circulate through the right atrium into the right ventricle, which will be down here. And the blood is then going to pass through this area between these two flaps. This area here, this squishy vessel that I'm pushing on right here, this is known as the pulmonary trunk. You could also call these the pulmonary arteries. The pulmonary arteries, again, arteries away. We're taking the blood that's deoxygenated and we're sending it to the lungs so that oxygenation can occur. So this little squishy blood vessel right here that's between these two flaps, that's called the pulmonary trunk. So oxygenation of the blood takes place in the lungs. It's going to come back to the heart through a pair of blood vessels that are called the pulmonary veins, which we're not going to see here. It's going to pass that blood into the left atrium. It will circulate through the left ventricle, and then it's going to come out of this blood vessel right here that's behind the pulmonary trunk. This blood vessel that's behind the pulmonary trunk, this is the aorta. So this is the aorta. Blood is going to come out of the aorta and cross around this bend here that we call the aortic arch. Now, above the heart, we're going to see two main arteries. You're going to see two arteries, one here on the left side of the trachea and one here on the right side of the trachea. Those are, respectively, the left common carotid artery and the right common carotid artery. And they're going to take blood up to the head. Now, to the side of my two carotid arteries, I'm going to see this red blood vessel that's going to be going down to my right arm, right here, and this blood vessel coming off of the aorta that's going to be going off to my left arm. These two blood vessels are the subclavian arteries. This is the left subclavian artery here as it comes off of my aorta. And this guy right here is my right subclavian artery, that little branch right there that's coming off of my aorta here. So those are the main arteries of the thoracic cavity. There is one vein that I want to point out that's going to be going, draining the head and entering into the superior vena cava, into the heart. And it's this blue guy right here. This blue blood vessel here, and you're going to see here on the left side, and there's one hiding over here on the right side. You can kind of see him. I didn't dissect him out, but a nice big guy right there. That big blue guy on the right side and this large blue guy on the left side are the external jugulars. They are going to be collecting the blood, the deoxygenated blood from the head, and draining it into the superior vena cava. Now, if I come back behind my lungs here and I'm pushing all of my organs over to the right, I will now see my aorta as it dips down. So here's the arch, and the arch will dip down. I got a little bit of connective tissue in there. I'll get that out of the way. But there's my arch. There's my aorta, aortic arch, and then here's my descending aorta. Now we're going to pass through the diaphragm here in a second. When we pass through the diaphragm, we typically call the aorta the abdominal aorta. And so I will pull that back right here. Here's my diaphragm. Here's my aorta as it's passing through the diaphragm. I'll move my diaphragm out of the way. And about right in here is where the diaphragm would be. Now we call the aorta, from here on out, the abdominal aorta.